these are the very big picture. So what we have covered, we have already covered regular language, that is the type 3 language. It is called as Chomsky's type 3 language. Remember, all these things has been developed in 1960s, and remember Turing machine has developed 1930, at least theoretical concept is there 1936-37. So there are some anomaly there. So this is the all this work of language side has been taken mostly done by Noam Chomsky, linguist, and we have covered this one. And this is the deterministic context-free language. Always try to remember the deterministic context-free language. What you can deterministically accept by a deterministic pushdown automata. If you tell me, sir, give me a proof the deterministic pushdown automata means deterministic context-free language, is proof is tough. But you have to remember it, that all deterministic context-free language is equivalent to, is must be accepted by a deterministic pushdown automata. And 99% of all programming languages, all programming languages are nothing but extension of our formal language. What we are learning here as a formal language, this is a formal language. What is the difference between the formal language and programming language? Programming language is nothing but an extension of formal language, and most formal language or programming languages are from deterministic context-free language. Very interesting. And I have already told you why regular language is insufficient for programming. That is the reason whenever the computer has come, we see a great jump in technology because of the programming capability. Everything you can program, not only at your computer, your washing machine, your car, your router, your mobile, your any damn thing at your house right now, it can be programmed. So it is really powerful. That is the programming capability. All programming is done by a deterministic context-free language. So what is the examples of deterministic context-free language? A to the power n, b to the power n. But a to the power n, b to the power n, it is very easy to visualize it. It can be accepted by pushdown automata. Another interesting deterministic context-free language is our parenthesis grammar. Because this parenthesis is used everywhere except Python. Python, there is not parenthesis, but there is a white space is there, is used. But in C, Java, you see the parenthesis plays a role for programming constructs. So that is deterministic. And then comes another interesting language, that is non-deterministic context-free language, that is palindrome language. Palindrome is by odd palindrome and even palindrome. This is very interesting language, but again, there's some few application in might be in programming languages, and all this is type 2. And then comes another interesting language, that is the context sensitive language. So if I already told a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n, just I asked another question: a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n, and d to the power n. Which kind of language it? Which kind of? It will be again a context sensitive language. So it doesn't matter whether a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n, d to the power n, e to the power n, all are context sensitive language. Again, I am giving another example. Say a to the power n, b to the power n, a to the power q, b to the power q. Which type of language it is? I am a to the power n, b to the power n, a to the power p, b to the power p. Which kind of language it is? A to the power n, b to the power n is a context-free language. Then you put another context-free language, a to the power p, b to the power p. So it is not context-sensitive language, it is a context-free language. Yeah, a to the power n, b to the power n, a to the power p, b to the power p, then a to the power q, b to the power q, all are context-free language, not context-sensitive language. What is context-sensitive language? A to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n, a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power q, d to the power n. Okay, so I can put a c to the power q in between, but I have to keep track a to the power n, b to the power n, then c to the power q, and again d to the power n. So these are all context sensitive languages. So it can be proved that context sensitive language can be accepted by a Turing machine. And the Turing machine, I have told you, that Turing machine called a linear bounded automata. Why it is linear bounded automata? Because you know Turing machine can go left and right, but it can go infinite, right side infinite. left side infinite, but there is a boundary. So there is hardly any difference between context sensitive language, another is type 0 language. What is the type 0 language? Type 0 language, just I context sensitive language means your left hand side should have a variable. It's not a single variable, it can be context sensitive language means it can be a string. It can be a string, left hand side should be a string, right hand side can be a string. Okay, but if you take mod of left hand side string, that is length of the left hand side string, and mod length of the right hand side string, it cannot right hand side cannot diminish the left hand side. That means right hand side length of the right hand side cannot be less than length of the left hand side string. Only one exception is there. What is the exception? That start variable can go to epsilon. So mod of start variable, say s, so mod of s is 1, mod of epsilon is 0. That is acceptable in all regular language or deterministic context free language or non deterministic language. But for all other string in context sensitive language, say left hand side a alpha, a string, and right hand side a gamma, another string. So mod of gamma, mod of right hand side cannot be less than left hand side. If it is, then it will call the type 0. What is the difference between type 1 and type 0? Context free also, and it is a context sensitive also. But I will take more concentric definition. So it is a context free. So why should I go for context sensitive? Because if I put context sensitive, then I have to put Turing machine. Turing machine is costly. Your Poisson automata is less costly, and your deterministic finite state machine is less costly. So I have to the language. What does it mean by language? Language has some grammar, and with this grammar, from start variable we can get some string of terminals. Now this string of terminals have to put on a machine, and machine says I am accepting or not accepting. The machine, if it is a regular language, I can put a finite state machine. If the language comes from context free grammar, I can put a machine of a push down automata. So that's it. So whenever I say a to the power n, b to the power n is a context free language, I can determine a push down automata. Whenever I say a to the power n, b to the power n, a to the power p, b to the power p, it is also a context free language. I can use the same push down automata. I do not have to employ two push down, one simple push down automata. So that is the reason I am telling is a deterministic context free language. Is every language has its complements also. Okay. So if it is understood by the language and its complement also, that is truly recognizable. So this type 0 language, this is recursive language, it is recognizable. It is fully recognizable. But here complement is not recognizable. So this is all this compiling. See here, we regular language, we have complexity O to the power n, and deterministic context free language O to the power O to the O, complexity is big O n cube. But by clever tricks we will make it O n only. For all programming languages we try to make parsing O n, that is linear. But here it will be all exponential, maybe 2 to the power n, like this, all from this, from context sensitive language till context free grammar, all are O n cube, and if n is number of terminals in a sentence, so it will be O n cube. But from context sensitive grammar, recursive language, recursive result, it is a exponential increase. So they are hardly used in programming languages, but these are the one of the research fields, because nowadays we have quantum computing and other things, we can recognize certain things. That is very interesting type of automata. So there are another interesting automata, grammar. So you always remember the automata and grammar and example sentences. One thing I have to palindrome, I have told you WWR. That is even palindrome. The WWR, another is odd palindrome. That is not WWR. That is, there is a one single letter should be there, and forward and backward would be the same. That is a odd palindrome. But whenever I say W hash WR, you know that is not a palindrome. Looks like a palindrome. that is definitely a deterministic context-free language, because you are giving a hash sign to indicate your pushdown automata that is the midpoint. So till hash, it will pushing onto the stack. When the hash is received, then it next onward is it popping off. So they will be matching. So that is it. So that is not a part. Now it is context sensitive language examples, A to the power n, B to the power n, C to the power n. Another example you should must remember, that is WW grammar. So it looks like WW grammar is a context free grammar. No, because whenever, how you can match a W may consist of a string ABCD, say ABBB, ABBB, then another W ABBB. So whenever you push ABBB in a stack, whenever this A comes, how to match the this A and the another A at the bottom of the stack? So pushdown automata will not be acceptable here. Again, it will be accepted by a Turing machine. That's it. The WW grammar and A to the power n, B to the power n, C to the power n grammar are context sensitive. Let's go. So these things I'll cover up later. So today our focus will be deterministic context-free language. And deterministic context-free language has a grammar, and one form I have covered in the last class, that is Chomsky's normal form. What is Chomsky's normal form? Your left hand side should be single variable and right hand side a terminal or two variable only. That is Chomsky's normal form. Any context-free grammar can be converted to Chomsky's normal form. That is great benefit for computer, for Prasad to generate. So this is leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation. This I took it from John Hopkins' book. That book is available with you. And that is, you have whenever you are given a terminal of a string, and you start from S will be starting. So and then you can start for your derivation. So whether you want to have derivation from the left hand side, so from the left hand side any variable is there, you try to derive it first. Remember, whenever you got it, the right hand side maybe 2-3 variables, do not at a time go for expansion all the in the parallel. So it will be either you go for leftmost variable to more derive, that is called leftmost derivation. That is the usual technique, leftmost derivation. And another technique is the rightmost derivation. You rightmost variable you go to. Remember, for any sentence consist of terminals, your leftmost derivation can give one and only parse tree for unambiguous grammar. And rightmost derivation also give another tree. The tree ultimately both are same. So that's it. So you, for a unambiguous grammar, any sentence you can have from leftmost derivation only one and only parse tree, from rightmost derivation one and only parse tree. Ultimately, whenever we say whether the parse tree is same, we consider only leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation, not both. Okay, about the derivation. So say your left side variable is S and right side variable is small a, capital B. Okay. So if we go for next stage, derive capital A first, then try to another string is then leftmost variable, that is called leftmost derivation. And if I go for B first, that is rightmost derivation, that is rightmost. This is, you can see is here, if we put it rightmost here, or whenever you say we apply number of rules, you say rightmost start. Okay. And same is leftmost derivation. We do this, and whenever you start, that is number of derivatives. So this is a context-free grammar. This I took it from John Hopkins' book. So here all the P, and these are the terminals, 0, 1 are the terminals. This is a context-free grammar of palindrome. So palindrome, there are lots of grammar. You should see lots of examples. Why? You should not go for only one example, because in your MCQ or maybe whenever it will be, they create a palindrome. Another interesting grammar, this is called expression grammar. So this is your basic fundamentals of all programming languages. So you consider C, Java, all our programming languages. It's like it is a addition, this is expression, this is identifier, expression is equal to expression plus this is plus, this is star, this is parenthesis, then you go for this. This is a simple expression, and this is, you remember, this is a Hauke's context free, because all these rules, left hand side only one and right hand side are all context free rules. Okay, these are all context free. So this particular rule maybe look like not context free, but this one damn context free, this one context free, this one context free. So the whole, if any one of the rule is context free, it will be context free. Okay. It is not a context sensitive, because if it's a context sensitive, there will be any terminal variable. So here, see this grammar, what is your variable? E and I, your variable. E and I. Variable are, in sometimes I say non-terminal. This is a terminal set. What are the terminal set? This plus, star, forward bracket A, begins, end. Like this is the terminal set. P is the set of productions. These are the set of productions. And the E is the start variable. So this is the grammar. You know what is the tuple of grammar tuple. First should be variable or non-terminal. This is the V. Sets of E and I, the two variables are there. P is the terminal set and P is the production. Okay, this is a example, and this is your tomorrow I will take answer from you. This is I am taking the exercise from the Hopcraft, and regarding your presentation, you try to get examples from the, say these are the production rules, and prove by induction that the string length is, no string has BA. That you try by induction, that is no string of BA can be there. And another exercise 5.1.8 is, so these are the grammar rules, grammar rules. Prove that LG is a set of all strings of equal number of A's and B's. So that is obvious, equal number of any productions you generate 1A, 1B, here also 1B, 1A are valid. So repeated applications, you have equal number of A and equal number of B. You try to prove it. Like this is ambiguity in grammar language. I have covered what is ambiguity, that your parsing tree should be unique. So which is the parsing tree, whether left hand, leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation. So leftmost derivation, one and only parse tree, rightmost derivation, one and only parse tree. These two parse trees must be similar. Left hand parse tree and right hand parse tree, you should not confuse. The ideal answer would be the left hand derivation or one and only parse tree. And if you go for all right hand derivation, one and only parse tree. They look alike, they are same, but we are not telling it left hand derivation and right hand derivation must be the same. Actually, we will take the left hand derivation. The left hand derivation about this thing, left hand and right hand. Left hand derivation, what is left hand derivation? We take the left hand variable to derive first, leftmost. But do not try to derive all the variable at a time. It is not parallel processing. So remember, you will be confused. Whenever you go for derivation for any star symbol to terminals, then this is generation. And the more tougher is the recognition. You are given a sentence, you are given a production rules, you have to find out the parse tree, how it is generated. Then you can get the meaning of the sentence, and that is the done by the our compiler, that is syntax analyzer, that is done. Syntax analyzer, then comes semantic analyzer, it is done. So whenever we write a programming languages, it basically it gives us strings of terminals. These terminals are given by a compiler get it encoded by only unambiguous grammar of a context. So that is it. So here you say there is a half baked chicken or half baked chicken. So there is a confusing. Okay. Call me a cab, okay, you are a cab. Like these are confusing. It is okay. It is interesting in English language, but it is not good for programming language. This is very simple. I'll just go to another one. This is ambiguity. I'll cover in another. Today, because last class also we have already done it, this is the Chomsky's normal form. So any context-free grammar should have, can be converted to Chomsky's normal form. Chomsky's normal form is, there are left-hand side one variable, right-hand side two variable, or a term. You can ask why, sir, why it is required Chomsky's normal form, because it is a binary and it is if it's because it's a binary, if you all production rules put into your Chomsky's dollar form, for parsing or recognition will be much better because it is a binary tree. Okay, it is a binary tree. A computer can understand binary logic very well. So that is the thing. Chomsky's normal form is a great form, and again, it's a wrong Chomsky's theorem. A variable can have two or can have one node. If it's a one node, that is a terminal. If it's a two node, it's a variable. And the key advantage is Chomsky's normal form. Every derivation of a string of n letters has exactly 2 minus 1 steps. You can verify. This is a typical question on MCQ. It will come. The how many number of steps? So if a string of n letters, it has exactly 2n minus 1. This calculate. Now the crucial part of it. This is a bit tough. Today I just give introduction. Next day I'll cover. This is what kind of? This is a context-free grammar. But this is not a Chomsky's normal form. Why? Because there is three. This is not two variable one. We have to convert into a Chomsky's normal form. How to convert it? Always you remember Chomsky's normal form. By visually you can convert like this. And another thing is always take a S0, a new start state. So I think you have take the original grammar. This is the original grammar, and we take a extra start. Just today I try to absorb this. This is a start variable. Why I am rejecting this start variable? Because this start variable can be here and can be here also, can be here. So if I take a fresh start variable, this S0 cannot be in rule. So that is the reason for any conversion, you must take a new start variable. So whenever you, this is a typical question in Chomsky's normal form conversion, and there are other some rules. If there are some rules like S is equal to A, say AB, and another slash is D. So we have to reject that rule because from D there is no terminals are coming. So that is called there are some production rules which are unreachable. So that rules have to be deleted. So whenever we will go for some rules which are unreachable variable or unreachable terminals, so that will be deleted. So here all are reachable. We all just take an extra S0 and this is it. And remove, then we remove epsilon rules. You remember what the Chomsky's normal form says? There can be only one epsilon, that is from the start variable. Whenever I say a new start variable, so what is the epsilon is here? B epsilon. This rule has to be removed. Okay, this how to remove? So first step is we take a zero, then remove epsilon rules and on the left, and so we any epsilon rules we have to remove. Then we can come to this. So what I do, I'll send the try to understand. So I think we can understand. So this is today I am covered Chomsky's normal form, and why Chomsky's normal form? Because it will have a only right hand side only two variables, not any number of variables. So we have to simplify the rules. Maybe after Chomsky's normal form, if you have original 10 rules, your Chomsky's normal form produce maybe 20 or 30. But if it is 20, that is a simpler for computer. So even the number doesn't matter here. The rules complexity is less for computer programmer because the right hand side will be two variable or a single terminal, or S can go, start variable can go to epsilon. Here our job is to make a Chomsky's normal form. So always if it is S is right side or not, you always take any extra S0. So this is the first rule. You do it, then you eliminate B to epsilon. How to eliminate B to epsilon? You put epsilon everywhere. Then those rules you attached. So this is whenever you S to A, because you put B is equal to epsilon. So that is the rule S to A. This rule is coming, S to A. This is the new rule. Now after removing B to epsilon, it comes to A to epsilon. Then you have to remove A to epsilon. So these are the steps you should not confuse. So you don't try to eliminate B to epsilon and A to epsilon in the same steps. First is S0, then you remove B to epsilon. So after removing B to epsilon, here A coming, then the A to epsilon comes, A to epsilon. So this has to be removed. Okay, so if you go for this, so remove the epsilon, then the A to epsilon. So then you have to remove A to epsilon. Then single variable to single variable have to be removed. It asks accepting this. Like this kind of rule have to be removed. Okay. Another grammar is very interesting. This is the final, this will be your conversion. It looks complicated, but it is, see, all are Chomsky's grammar. All are Chomsky. This is the original rule. How many rules are? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 rules, and here, what is the rule? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 10, 15, 16, 17, 18. 18 rules are there, but these 18 are simpler than this because all rules are the two variables. Another is the Graybeck normal form. There are two formal normal form is there. One is Chomsky's normal form, another is Graybeck normal form, which is, remember, she is a lady, computer scientist, a great computer scientist. There are few ladies in the computer science. Start from, though the programming language is, you know, the ADA has developed. Graybeck normal form is says, it is different from Chomsky, it is a variable vector set. It first starts with a terminal and any number of variables. So this is different, but this is another useful but abnormal form. So it says left hand side one variable, right hand side only one terminal, or a terminal all are variable, not two. 1, 2, 3, 4, many. So this is a Graybeck normal form. Thank you very much.